Brockton is a blue-collar city. Brockton is, you know, tough scrabble city. We love to see kids succeed in any way. Now you see a kid like Matt Parziale who, you know, is taking the golf world by storm, and he's doing it while he's holding a full-time job.
So this is the Brockton Fairgrounds. My dad used to take me right up here to this field. This is where I started hitting shots. We'd just come up with the shag bag. My grandfather would come too. Looks a little different now, but that's where it all began.
So I wanted to become a firefighter because my dad was a firefighter.
I was a firefighter in Brockton for 32 years and finished up as a captain.
I watched him his whole life, my whole life, love his career. I've known a bunch of the guys even before I got on and always enjoy being around them. And the fact that I'm able to be one of those guys now is a dream come true.
I thought it was great. I know the type of person he is. I knew he'd be a good firefighter. He respects the authority and he works hard.
Ladder one here in Brockton is the seventh busiest ladder in the country. So we stay pretty busy, but it's good to be busy and always keeps you ready to go.
A lot of people ask me if I worry about him, and I don't really worry about him because I know the job, how we go about it, and we play it safe. You know, I'm happy to see him doing it. He's a good firefighter.
What are you getting, good?
I'm gonna get the skinny chick omelet. If there is onions, no onions.
The first date, I brought her golfing.
Yeah, he did. That is true. And he told me he was like, I'm pretty good at golf, but I thought he was just kind of making it up, like trying to impress me. And then turns out he actually is good at golf, so.
Did the wedding get moved?
Yeah.
So to skip the USAM for the wedding, in my mind, wasn't an option.
So once Matt started winning in the tournament, I knew changing the wedding day might definitely be a possibility. And then I saw that the Pebble Beach tournament was the date of our wedding. So I was, and that was win or lose after the last day he was going to Pebble Beach, right?
Yeah, no, it worked out good. Good for me.
We found another date that works for everyone, and it's going to be an exciting August.
Great answer.
I know. I was very nailed it.
So we're heading to the Strand Memorial. It's a monument they put in honoring the Strand Theater Fire back March 10th, 1941, where the city of Brockton lost 13 firefighters. And before 9/11, it was the biggest loss of firefighter life in one incident. They do something right here every March 10th, and all the firefighters come and they do a presentation and they do a good job with it, so to remember it.
Well, the city of Brockton is referred to as the city of champions because of the two boxers who grew up here, Rocky Marciano and Marvin Hagler.
Brockton High, we got Rocky Marciano Stadium here. And they did the statue of Rocky here a few years back.
You used to hear all the stories growing up. My great-grandmother used to go to Rocky's house the nights he would fight to cover up the radios and TV so Rocky's mom wouldn't watch or hear the fight because she'd get too nervous when he was fighting. So, yeah, pretty cool story there.
He's a champion of the 37th U.S. Mid-Amateur Championship. And here's the Bob Jones Trophy for Matt.
It's unbelievable. It's a historic win. It's something that I'll be telling my children about for years. Extremely proud of them, and
yeah,
it's been an amazing, amazing year, and couldn't be happier for them.
Yeah, out of everybody, I was so happy that you got that done. And I remember when I saw that picture of him and his father, I started to tear up because I thought it was one of the most amazing pictures I'd ever seen in my whole life.
It's interesting to see him as I've watched him grow up. I watch him now, and you know, I have kids of my own. I watch them playing sports. I think it's important for the kids of this city to be able to see and say, hey, this is a blue-collar city, but golf can be any man's game.
That's what most people say, that he's as good of a person as a golfer, and that's important to me.
It really shows that, you know, when you have good parents, you have good children. And Matt and his father, you see, you know, caddying for him all the time. It's really a special thing. It's a special thing for all of us that have children to watch, you know, and something to strive for, you know, as parents.
One of his friends said, I'm caddying for you at Shinnecock, Matt. This is before the tournament even started. And I said, well, it could happen, but we'll see. But I'm caddying for him.